My name is Sam Yarosh, and here at Sandbox, my day-to-day work focuses mostly on running the business, thinking about our business development and finding new customers, as well as thinking about new areas that we can apply AQ technology to help solve different kinds of problems, you know, beyond the ones that we're already focused on today. So in that capacity, I spend a lot of my time looking at two different types of things. On one hand, I look at different types of people or companies, you know, customers, quote unquote, who might benefit from the services and the products that we offer. And then on the other side of it, I also do a lot of thinking about ways that we can apply the technology that we have to different use cases and different types of customers. So it's both who's going to, you know, buy the work that we build or the products that we build, and also how can we build new products to solve new and different things. It's close to my heart as somebody who has forever been interested in STEM, I'll call it, right? But really science and the cutting edge of discovering new things about the world around us. I grew up and was always interested in physics, and I studied physics in college, but part of why I want to talk about this topic is after I graduated, I did nothing related to AQ, not even remotely close. Even though it was close to my heart intellectually, it wasn't the path that I found myself going down and thought this was never something that would be accessible to someone like me with the skill set that I was building. It's such a treat to be able to spend or to have been able to find a role at a place like Sandbox that allows me to actually return a bit closer to that intellectual stimulation that I want so badly. And really, again, what I'm so passionate about and what's been such a surprise, honestly, is how easy it's been, relatively speaking, to apply, you know, general business skill sets in the AQ world. Again, something I thought I wouldn't be able to do without this deep technical background. It's not so much that the technology or the concepts are easy. I don't think anyone would claim that. But the combination of the welcoming nature of this community, both at Sandbox and beyond, has taught me so much and has been so patient with someone like myself and helping me to, you know, constantly ask questions and be okay with, you know, walking me through different concepts and encouraging me to learn. I think that has been, like I said, that both the biggest surprise and the biggest enabler for someone like me to, you know, really open up and be vulnerable and realize that I don't know all the answers, but that I can kind of synthesize what I learn every day here, apply some of the concepts that I do know well, and, you know, in turn kind of create new and better things to solve some of the world's toughest problems. So that's why I spend time in AQ. It's a little bit about my journey, and if nothing else, it's a call to anybody who might be a little bit intimidated by the technology or by, you know, how much of the time we spend on the cutting edge. This is a place for everybody where anyone can really add value and kind of find their place in this community. And, you know, I can say, you know, me as one of these people would welcome anybody else who's excited and interested to come join us. Something that I think we all experience is imposter syndrome or doubt in ourselves. And I think it's, for me, as someone who comes to the AQ world with a non-technical or non-traditionally technical background, it's something that I faced the moment that I even considered joining a place like Sandbox. And so that imposter syndrome for me actually hit, you know, as I found out that I might have a chance to chat with some folks and even interview. I found myself looking in the mirror and the narrative went through my mind of, oh, there's no way you'll be able to answer these questions. There's no way you'll be able to speak with any kind of confidence on these topics. And, you know, from that moment, I think it was kind of a make or break situation for me in so many ways. I was fortunate enough to have so many people in my life outside of Sandbox and outside of the AQ world that, you know, encourage me constantly. But there's one real moment for me here that kind of helped me take the next step forward, is I even mentioned that to the person who I was initially connected with at Sandbox and said, hey, you know, I'm not really sure I have the technical chops for this. And there was an immediate kind of dropping of all other pretense or anything else about the conversation we were going to have, and saying, this is something that we're all learning about every day. It's a place where we realize we're not going to be able to solve problems if everyone here comes with the same background and the same perspective. And for me, that was a real eye opener and a way to set me at ease of saying, okay, it's not that my, you know, the difference of my background is a hindrance. It's actually a valued perspective. And so getting over it, I wish I had a silver bullet for anyone individually to solve imposter syndrome. I think for me, the best thing, or the way that it's worked, is just to be vulnerable about that and realize that people here and, you know, others in this community really want to help build you up and you know, help you find your place rather than put you down and exclude you from the work that we're doing.